Oh god, this is going in the bin.
Hello, I want to do a soft glam makeup look. I've just basically done a first impression, like started a first impression on the House Labs Triclone Skin Tech Foundation, and this is how it's looking. I'll upload this first impression before this video, so you can go watch it. I'll link it below. Lots of people have asked for my, you know, review on this product, and I'm sorry it took me so long. I kind of forgot I had it, and then a few people requested it when I did a question box recently, and I was like, oh my god, I have that. So I've done it now. My bad. I really want to try out the, what shade was it? Radiant? I want to do a look centered around Radiant. Let me swatch it so you can remember. I showed this in one of my recent Get Ready With Me's where I did like a green and yellow look. Sounds kind of ugly, but it was one of my favorite makeup looks I've done lately. So I'll link that video below if you want to go check it out. This color is unreal. It's like peach nude. Like I'm obsessed with it and I want to see what it looks like with like a soft glam. So I want to do like glam makeup, but I want it to, yeah, soft. I want it soft. I want it beach girly, Victoria's Secret-ish. I'm going shopping today, so I kind of just want to look pretty and I don't want to look over the top. So I don't know, let's just see how it turns out. Hopefully it turns out well and I don't feel like crap. I could really go for another coffee. I've just popped in my order to Hamish. She was like, okay, what do you want? I feel like a vanilla latte vibe, so let's see how he does. Honestly, the coffee machine's going great. We haven't bought a single coffee since we bought the machine. I mean, hello, the machine. Like, we've probably spent close to a grand on, like, getting the machine, getting the coffee, getting some accessories we wanted to get. Maybe not a grand, but, I mean, getting close to it. But also, I'm like, well, if this coffee machine lasts us for, like, I don't know, 5 years. There's people in my DMs that have had this coffee machine for, like, 8 years, 6 years. So I'm like, you know, it'll pay itself off one day. Am I delusional? I don't know. Oh, I really want to try one of these too. I found these. I was like, oh my god, I forgot. I'm always forgetting about what I've got in my collection. This is the sign that I need to do my declutter sooner rather than later. Are you guys keen for like a whole nother declutter series? Because even my new stuff drawer needs a declutter because there's too much stuff in there. So I'll do giveaways and things. But anyway, also two people haven't answered me for the giveaway. So please check the down bar. And if you're one of the winners, can you just write in the comments section your Instagram username. This is why I don't do just like YouTube giveaways very often. Like I always usually do them over on Instagram. I direct you to Instagram. YouTube comments and messaging systems are terrible and it like senses everything and it, sorry, I'm talking so much right now. But it like sent, like people can't write in their email. They can't write in things and it's just so difficult to communicate. So yeah, I'll probably do more giveaways over on Instagram just cause it is literally so much easier. If you don't have Instagram, you can always just make an account literally just to enter my giveaways. I don't care if you don't post anything, like you just have to follow me. I don't even care if you don't use it. Like it's literally just so I can contact you. I want to do bronzer first. I feel like this year I need some brands to put out some fun new bronzers because all of my favorites are still like really, you know, ones I loved years ago, like the Too Faced Love Heart bronzer, my Hourglass one. I literally have so many cream and liquid bronzers and no new powder ones. Like it's doing my head in. Does anyone know of any bronzers that have launched lately? I want to do like I just want to shop some. Anyways, I've chosen this today, Glowish, Soft Radiance and Light. We've kept Porter home from daycare today since like I'm obviously filming, he's just gone for a nap, but like we don't have like heaps of stuff to do today. So I was like, oh, well, I can film, Hamish can like chill with him and then we can take him to the shops with us later. He's usually pretty good at the shops. Like he's quite patient. Eventually he does crack it like any normal toddler. But then we can like take him to the park. We always do little like breaks like that, like in between if we're doing a couple of shops. Often, you know, if we need to go to like the garden shop and then we need to go to the supermarket or something, we'll like stop at the park in between, let him have a big run around, go for a bit of a walk, and it resets him. He has a snack, he has some water, and we're good to go again, like for him to sit in the pram. We're still at that stage where like when he runs around the shops, it's just a nightmare because he just wants to pick up everything and carry it around, and I'm like, you can't do that. But he's at the stage where like he's not old enough to understand that yet, and so tantrums. But we're getting there. We're, you know, reinforcing every time and like trying to like teach him these things. It's just the tantrums are real. It's quite funny though sometimes, like, so for example, we were at the warehouse, I don't know, 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, and he found a bubble gun that was a shark. And he actually has one of these already up at our beach house. that we play with up there. So he obviously saw it, he recognized it, and he wanted it. And I was like, actually, yeah, I'll buy one for here too, because it's really cool. It's like $6 and it just blows all these bubbles and it's great fun, right? So I grabbed it and like I let him hold it because he wanted to hold it, he wanted to walk around with it, but he wanted it out of the box. And I'm like, no, we can't take it out of the box just yet. We've got to buy it first. And to him, he was like, this is the stupidest rule and it makes no sense at all. So of course he wanted to have a tantrum, right? But it's kind of wholesome. Like his version of the tantrum was to literally carefully crawl down onto the ground, carefully lay on his back, put his arms up and just like glare at me. And he just laid there. I'd go to pick him up and he'd be like, and like flop backwards and like go all like boneless. And I was just like, okay, stay down there then. But it was kind of funny, you know, like he definitely has the arms and legs going all over the show tantrums as well, but it just made me laugh. Like it's one of those situations where as a parent I'm trying not to laugh because I'm trying to be serious and like, you know, communicate with him, which is very hard to communicate with, you know, a child that's not even two yet, because they understand a lot but also don't understand a lot, and they don't understand the why. Like to them, like they just want to do whatever they want to do and they don't understand that they can't just do whatever they want to do. It's the things you don't think about before you become a mum or a parent, like these little situations. It's like difficult because it's like, how do I actually explain that, like, you can't take it out of the box? So yeah, I try to keep him in the pram because it just makes life easier for all of us. Got my iPhone, worst case scenario, lock the iPhone, give him a Elmo video. Ooh, unpopular opinion, I do not care about screen time whatsoever. If he needs screen time or if I need the screen time for him, like if I'm burnt out, I've got nothing against it. I'm gonna do, like I said, a very soft glam eye, and so I'm thinking very light browns. Do I just use we'll have a look at Kmart today. This looks yum, smells good. Oh, it smells real good.
You said with vanilla, I put a little bit in, but it's quite a small cup.
Oh, it's yum. Yeah. You have to make Kelly one of these, she'll like that. Honestly, Hamish is so good at making coffee. These taste better than the ones at the shop, I swear. Oh, yum. Anyways, I'm gonna just take this bronzer. Simple. I will darken it a little bit, but I just wanna kinda keep it light, and I don't wanna just go in with like a dark eyeshadow and just make it like real dramatic straight away. Hopefully this just helps. May as well use the palette I used in my last video, the Yucca. We'll just go in with Valley, which I used last time, because I feel like this is the perfect darkness. You know, I don't want anything too dark, and I just feel like that's nice. This eye look's going to be boring, by the way. Like, it's all about just the duochrome. It's not going to be anything creative, okay? I'm literally going shopping. Actually, today, before I realized I needed to go, you know, get my mum a present and stuff, I was thinking like, oh, I'll do my video where I'm gonna try like the EXO beauty collections that I don't think I'm gonna launch. Part of me wants to launch it because I'm so attached to it, but it's like, I just think it would be a flop. And in this economy with business so hard, business is so hard right now, I cannot, like, I just don't think I should risk it. But yeah, anyways, I'm gonna do like a video showing it and talking about it and talking about why I like certain things about it, or maybe I don't, or like ask for opinions. I don't know, I don't know what the vibe of the video would be until I really film it. Like, I don't want to plan it, I just want to do it. And I was going to do that today, but there is a lot of color in it, which is another reason I was like, I just don't know if it's right for right now, because everyone's like into the soft glam, everyone's into the no makeup makeup. I feel like the 2014 2016 makeups like making a comeback, but also I feel like people are just saying that because I still don't see a lot of people wearing fun makeup still. So like launching a fun makeup collection, I don't know. And it sucks because like normally what I do is I just launch whatever I love, and it's always been a success because I've got so many of you amazing people that are on my wavelength. But just with the way business is right now, I'm like, is it a risk? I feel like it's more of a risk at the moment, just with the climate of the world, with the economy. We feel it so hard out. Like, people, you know, I get it, you're not spending money on false eyelashes and things. And since the, like, pandemic, people don't wear false lashes as much. Like, I've noticed that. And I reckon that's also what's kind of, like, created this trend of, like, the no makeup makeup and the very soft glam makeup and stuff like that. I reckon it's because we went through like a pandemic and like people weren't wearing the same things, people weren't going out, you know, lipstick was such a huge trend before the pandemic, and afterwards it's not really been, because probably of like masks and stuff, you know, like all of these things make a big impact on trends. So I'm going in with Radiant. I kind of want to swatch Scented just in case. Oh, that's so pretty. It's more chunky. Okay, I'm going to start with Radiant because that's the color I wanted to use. Let me just use my finger, actually. My nails aren't too long right now, so... like, literally this color. Hold on. Let me come in closer. I always forget that I can zoom in. It's my little second layer. It's so much prettier in real life. It's got this soft, like, peachy gold reflect. I just think it looks gorgeous. I'm going to take the other color, which is called Scented. Let's just use both, but I'll put this one on the, like, middle. This color is a little bit more beige in reflect than, like, the peachy gold. So it's just, like, a little bit more, like, cooler or, like, neutral toned. I do prefer Radiant just because of that like peachy color. I think it's gonna look really nice. Like I might do a peachy blush and like, you know, I think the peachy colors suit the brown liner I'm gonna do. By the way, loads of requests to do another like liquid activated, water activated eyeliner palette. People love this thing. Like I get so many requests to do more and we are looking into it. I just need to get my ass into gear and commit. But let me know what kind of colors you would like to see. I get so many compliments on this thing. People just saying it's so easy to use and it's just beautiful and they're obsessed. So I need to do one. Definitely, obviously need to do a black. But what other colors would you like to see? I'm thinking purples and stuff because I love purples. And actually in one of my rejected collections, you know, that I've just been rambling on about, did actually have another water activated eyeliner palette that I can show you. Maybe some of those colors I could like reuse in a different collection or whatever. I'm also doing a collection. We're actually kind of planning like a collaboration, which is really exciting. I've never done it before, so that's really exciting. But we're still in like the very early days. But I can't wait to share more information about that with you. Hopefully later in the year. All right, I'm thinking I'm gonna darken the outer area of my crease a little bit just to give, I've got a fluff on my lash, just to give a little bit more dimension, but I still want it to be soft. I might just mix together Valley and Flax. Flax, I'm thinking it's like a little bit too dark. Kind of applying on top of the shimmer, just so that it still peeks through, but darkening the outer V. I feel like I'm doing like bridal makeup vibes right now. I feel like this foundation looks very flawless so far. Obviously, you've probably already seen my first impression. Hopefully it continues to perform well on my skin. Do you know what videos I've been loving watching on TikTok lately? I really want to do my own, but I never commit. Like I just always forget to do my own. But I really love the videos of people making sandwiches. Like I love it. I can't scroll past them. All right, so I'm doing that. It's kind of a little bit darker on the outer corner than I was really planning, but at the same time I think it looks nice, so we can roll with it. And I can always blend it out a little bit if I need to. I'm just using whatever's left on my puff right now. I set my under eyes with this earlier today. And I'm just kind of like brightening up that outer corner. I do want to do a little bit of lower lash action, but I think just with Valley, the more medium brown. Yeah, I saw this little quote which made me feel a little bit nicer about life. And it was like, you know, people our age, like if you're a similar age to me or obviously older, have lived already through like changing from like no social media to social media growing up and everything, which is a adjustment. Also through two recessions and a pandemic. I want to do the peach blush, okay? We're going to do the peach blush now and then I'll do like the rest of my eye makeup soon. I just really want to put peach blush on. I've got a specific color in mind, so let me see if I can find something like what I'm imagining. Okay, literally this. This is a Care Bears She Glam blush. I don't know what the color is. Look how cute the packaging is. Like I die. Literally like this creamsicle like peach is what I'm looking for. Oh my gosh. No, this is so pretty. It's even prettier than I thought it would be. And this is exactly the vibe I was imagining when I was talking about this eyeshadow color from the Lightwork palette. I'm just kind of like buffing this in. This next step may make or break the look. I'm gonna take Radiant again as a highlighter. In certain lightings, this can reflect more green. So I'm praying it doesn't look green on my cheekbone, but I'm just gonna do a really small amount. Oh gosh, it's so pigmented that this is like really intense. I'm literally just skimming my skin. Oh my god, it's so pretty. I can hear Porter sprinting around upstairs. Hamish put him to bed at his normal nap time and he's just like, nah. So Porter's back up now and he's doing laps upstairs by the sounds of it. I think that made it. It made the look. I would love to be able to set this down with some setting spray to make it like super like melting into my skin, but I'm doing a first impression, so I'm not gonna use setting spray today. I love this. And there must be other ones because this one says volume V, whatever that is. Like I want all of them. I love it. Oh, they look so pretty as a highlighter. Like I'm literally obsessed. Look how pretty it is on my nose. Okay, we're gonna do brows. And once again, I want them to look fairly soft. So I don't know, I'm just gonna start by filling in the tail. And then I think I'll just do the bare minimum and use a brow gel. I'm gonna use the Uoma, what color is this? I've lost the sticker, so I'm not sure what the color is, but it's the blowout brow gel. And it's probably like a medium brown shade, judging what I normally go for. And I like this because it is a little bit more like liquidy. A lot of my other ones are fiber ones, which I do like, but sometimes I like something quite liquidy and this one's quite liquidy. Another liquidy one I love is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Gel. I just think sometimes they look nice and polished because they add like almost like a little bit of a I just defied gravity. Like I threw that in a way that doesn't make sense. Anyways, it just makes them look, yeah, quite polished and different look to the fiber ones, you know. I think this one does it have fibers in it, or is that just my own brow hairs that have got stuck in there? There's so many ways to love you. Can you finally make me want to say oh. Also I think I'm gonna put some of that color, the groundwork one, on my brow bone because I just think it'll look nice. I'm not gonna do too much, just a little scratching. So fun. All right, I'm doing brown liner. We may as well just use this since I was already talking about it. I'm gonna do the darker brown and literally I just take like some setting spray or water. You can directly wet your brush or you can just wet this and like spill your brush in. Doesn't really matter, do whatever works for you. Which I would do, but I just can't find anything because my room's a mess again. Here we go, just gonna spray that to make it wet. Literally just take your brush. I'm just gonna do a nice brown wing. I'll probably just do like the liner that kind of stops halfway rather than like all the way across. Just keep it a little bit more minimal since I don't want to look too full on, full glam. And what I love about these is you can like mix the colors together and create custom shades as well. Pop a discount code down below if you want to try anything from EXO Beauty. You can use a discount code and save some money. Look how pretty that is. That color looks perfect and it's a little bit warm, so just kind of goes with all of the peach and everything that's happening. Now I'm not even sure if you can still get this, but I just think this color will be perfect with the look today. It's the Stila Topaz eyeliner. It's a nude, but it's very 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 like peachy. Ouch, stabbed myself in the eye. See what I mean? It's like super peach, which is kind of nice with this. And then mascara. I think I'll just do black still. I was going to do brown, but I'll just do black because I might just chuck on a few little cluster lashes just for a bit of fun. I'm going to use this Bare Minerals Lash Domination. Literally so many of the mascaras in my drawer, like a year old or longer. This one included. A very like wet formula. I can't even remember if I like this. Like it's just been sitting in my drawer unloved for so long. Yeah, I feel like it's not really doing anything for me right now, but whatever. I'm committing. Honestly, this coffee,
Even if I wasn't gonna wear falsies, like after this, I would have to. Oh god, this is going in the bin.
It's gone everywhere. And it's in my hair now. Oh my god. Couldn't go too well. It's just here to humble me.
Any normal person would like stop using the said mascara and like use something else, but I'm just committed to the cause and it's not good.
I'm gonna go in with my Tarte mascara. I love this is the tubing one. And I'm just gonna like add some and hope that it helps make the lashes look a little bit better. Like comb them out a little bit almost, because yeah, they're all like clumped up. I've literally got mascara all under my under eye now.
All right, I now have like 5 eyelashes rather than 2 or 3. So, I mean,
there's mascara everywhere. We're just gonna let it dry. Just don't look at it for a while. Literally, I swear, I'm always struggling to find lash glue. And considering I own my own lash glue, you would think, you know, you'd think I'd have stockpiles, but apparently not. Oh my god, even my false lashes look like shit because my real lashes are so weighed down. Like that mascara literally just made them like point downwards, which this is not a problem I have like normally. Let's see if I can like curl them. I'm probably gonna rip off all of those falsies. Surprisingly not. Oh, kind of. Okay, the lashes are a disaster today. Like everything just looks bad. Like there's just no fixing. Whatever. I'm literally just gonna stop there and just match the other side. Like I have so many more to put on, but I'm just like over it. They don't even look good.
It's fine. It's fine. Hopefully the mascara has dried enough that I can flake it off my lid.
I should have just used a mascara I like. Honestly, the blush and highlighter combo today is just literally giving me life though. Like it's making everything better.
Just gonna use this brush to blend the outer corner out a little bit.
Other than that, I think the eyes are just like a lost cause at this point. Apricot Kiss. Like to go with the theme. See, this peach makeup today is much more like your apricot peach than the Valentine's Day look I did recently, which was peach. That one was more like pink and peach, you know, like peach. And these colors are just so pretty. Like I love lip blush, creamy lip and cheek stain. Just feels like a lip stain, like the Benefit ones. I mean, look, you could wear that just every day, even with no makeup. Just to give your lips a little tint of color, build it up a little bit. You could get that like K-Beauty ombre lip. I mean, it looks really pretty.
Obviously, I like a really defined lip, but some of you guys might like this look without lip pencil. But for me, I love lip pencil, okay? Like it's literally one of my favorite steps to do because I love defined lips, but I know not everyone does. Let me zoom you out a little bit.
I think this foundation looks so good. I'm excited. Hopefully it lasts ages on my skin. It's only been on for like an hour, so you know. I feel like this color could be quite nice, but I have no idea what it's called because it's She Glam and they don't put the actual name on the lip pencil. 523.
I don't know. I wonder if I can figure it out and write it in the down bar. They come in like little packs.
See what I mean? Like it's just like a really nice color against that stain. Right, so I like the way this is looking. I think I just need like some lip oil to kind of just, I don't know, my lips look dry. Oh, in my last video, I pronounced this wrong and I knew I did. I wasn't sure how to pronounce it and you guys have helped me. Have I learned? Tell me my pronunciation now. La Jolla. La Jolla? La Jolla. Is that how you say it? Spell it like La Jolla. It's a nude. Actually, you know what? I'm just gonna pop this on. This is the ultimate nude lip gloss, guys. If you can still get it, I should check. I actually didn't even check when I used it in my last video. I just linked to Colourpop because I'm useless sometimes, but it is a very good nude. You can apply like heaps and it's like the biggest, juiciest Pamela Anderson lips you could imagine. Like it, you know what this reminds me of? Oh my God, it's just clicked with me. What the heck was that lip gloss? The iconic NARS lip gloss. I'm googling it right now. Turkish Delight. Is this just like Turkish Delight vibes? I mean, it's different, but it gives that vibe. Turkish Delight's a little bit more pinky. I would say this is a little bit more like neutral. I don't even know if you can see. Anyway, if you know, you know. I don't know if I like this lip combo now with the lip pencil. No, I don't like it. I like this But I think I'm going to go more like just nude rather than like the peachy lip liner. And I feel like it's too much. So let's just quickly start over.
The color I actually want to use is called Wifey by XO Beauty, but I think mine's in my clutch upstairs.
Maybe we'll use NP 2.5 Leon by Natasha Denona.
I need to sharpen it though.
Story of my freaking life. I'm gonna have to find a lip pencil that I don't need to sharpen. I can't find my sharpener anywhere. Here we go. Nude number one by Nabla. I think this will work. Just to define. Ew, what is in my mouth?
See, now I like the matte look with this lip pencil. I don't know, but just a sheer layer. And then just because I've already put on the lip gloss, I can go in with Haze by Anastasia Beverly Hills, which is like this ridiculously pale lipstick. And because I've got the gloss on first, it'll just transfer like way less, just to lighten it a little bit in the center.
Why am I loving like low-key the concealer lips again? Can we make these like come back? Like MAC Myth Natural Nymph by e.l.f. Cosmetics back in the day when they had their like little studio range, which was like big news because before that they only had like the $1 makeup. Remember it was in like the black little thing. Anyway, my lashes look like shit, but I really like the rest of my makeup, especially the blush, the highlighter, like the eyeliner look I love.
Yeah, the makeup's pretty. I mean, it's nothing I haven't done like something similar before, but I don't know, I just felt like filming this because I did like mention to you guys that I really wanted to use the color from this palette on my lids and try it out. So, you know, just a chill get ready with me, really, for me to run errands. That's what everyone says, when they're just doing like normal shit. I'm going to run errands. I guess that's what an errand is, isn't it? I don't know.
I feel like saying I'm running errands is not a New Zealand thing. Like before YouTube was a thing and before TikTok was a thing, like I never heard anyone say that. Like, I never heard my mum be like, oh, we need to go do some errands. If anything, you say, like, I need to go to town. And, like, that just meant we're going into the city, we're gonna go do things, like, pay bills, go to the post office, like, all the things that you used to do back in, like, you know, the early 2000s.
And now we say running errands, like, the people overseas.
I don't know, maybe that's just me. Any other Kiwis want to chime in on that?
I'm gonna go now. I'm gonna go chill out for the rest of Porter's nap time. And then we're gonna head into town and get some shiz done. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye bye.
Oh, my elbow just clicked.